What the mirror does is enable the person we are interacting with to see themselves. They know us because they are in some ways talking to themselves.
I've done my ortho and rheumatology flashcards. I went through all the material and put it into flashcards. I also went through all the rheumatology questions. Now we're headed to neurology, and you can see it's so dreadful for me to study neuro, but I'm really going to make an effort here on this semester.
Suave em 0 é 5%, o 0 ainda há 0% de crédito.
O 4 vai ter...
대학생 김철수는 여자친구와 데이트를 하던 중 화장실에 가 여자친구에게서 떨어지라며 박 씨의 얼굴을 가격합니다.
I don't want to break this. Oh. Today has been kind of lovely, like it's been really sunny, but for some reason the sun just went down and now there's no sun in my room. I want to thank so much everyone who supported me and sent me the sweetest messages during my finals. I'm happy to say I passed everything nicely. The last exam that I did was the worst that I did this semester, but the other three were awesome and I'm really proud of myself. I think I did really good. This fourth year wasn't, like, so much has happened during rotations and during COVID. Like I went through so many hospitals, I talked to so many tutors, I did so many evaluations, and now so many exams. My brain, it just gets really, like... So the first exam was the one that I was most concerned about. That was, like, fine. The second and third one went fine as well. The fourth one, I think the reason why it didn't go as well was because I didn't have much time to study, like, at all. I wouldn't say burnout, but it was just like I was getting tired of 2 months of studying or whatever. It was definitely an exam where you had to have had studied throughout the semester a little bit more, and I kind of slacked off on that subject. I just attended classes and kind of just wrote some notes, and at the end of the semester it proved to not be enough, but it's fine. You know, I've come to realize how to handle my grades in a much better way. I'm not too attached to the results. Of course I care, and of course at the end I'm like always, oh, I wish I have done better and I wish I did these things better. And then there's always like this shock and this like, oh no, feeling, because you do spend a lot of time preparing for them, and so you want to have results to account for that. But I guess because I've done so many exams at this point, I know that I'm going to be okay, and I know that I have to focus on the next one, and the next one will go better. Generally speaking, like, I've been improving, and even though I am a horrible test taker, I always second doubt myself. Even though that's true, I've been improving throughout the years of college. If you guys don't know, I'm a fifth year now, and there's 6 years of college for me, so I'm almost there. It's been a wild ride so far, and I've noticed improvement, and I think that's what you should focus on. It's like doing better, but at the same time being proud and realizing what you did do good. Just been studying at different places, like at the library, at home. It's been pretty lonely. It's been a kind of an isolating season for me. I haven't felt really burnout. I felt tired, but I didn't feel burnout. I just wanted to keep going. You know, after finals, like, all my friends go to their respective places, and I can't really schedule anything with them, or I don't know. It's always by myself, which I'm fine with that. I am an introverted type of person. I want to be as open as possible with my social activities, which to me is really low. Like, the bar is really low for me, but during summer it's like the lowest ever, because I don't really see anyone. So I think I'm just going to keep studying throughout the summer. I'm not really gonna be doing anything at all, like traveling or any of the sorts. I never do, really. This summer is really not going to happen. I'm pretty sure I'm going to be taking my driver's license, so that's really cool. I'm really excited to take my driver's license. It's something that I wanted to do for a few years now. But yeah, only now my family has been like, okay, we're going to afford this to you. So I'm really excited and really grateful that they decided to do that. By my family, I mean my parents. I'm really excited. I couldn't help myself, and I watched like these free video lectures on speed limits, which I thought was really fun. It's just like an hour lecture online on speed limits. And I thought it was just really fun that for once I'm not talking about human body. I'm just talking about like how fast you can go on a freeway and stuff. It's really funny to me. What I'm going to be studying, wanted to focus on my weak points, because I do have a lot of weak points. I've improved a lot with antibiotics and all of the infectious diseases points. I've improved a ton this year. Still want to improve more on that. Please don't take that as like, oh, I shouldn't rest during the summer, because that's definitely not the case. I want to do a few things during the summer. I want to draw. I want to visit some museums, look at some art. I really want to go to the beach, since I do live in a very ocean-sided country, so I did want to go to the beach. And so I'm going to show the books that I'm hopefully going to read this summer.
I'm so happy just looking at them. So the first one is Wuthering Heights. I've been reading this ever since finals got a lot easier on me. And I'm already almost done. It's been a wild experience reading this. Definitely like a lot easier than I thought it would be. After the first few pages, I got a hang of this story. And the cover is absolutely beautiful. It's a Penguin English Library book. It does have a conclusion by Virginia Woolf. The back cover said that Wuthering Heights has achieved an almost mythical status as a love story, yet it is also a unique masterpiece of the imagination, an unsettling, transgressive novel about obsession, violence, and death. And that, I think that describes it perfectly.
It's a little whale and a little cloud.
Blind Willow, Sleeping Woman by Haruki Murakami. These are short stories and they're kind of fantastical. I've explained this in the vlog, actually, I do remember. So I won't go into it really, but I want to finish this after Wuthering Heights. This is Virginia Woolf Diaries. I always have to read Virginia Woolf during the summer because I just have to. I don't know why. It just happened for the past 2 years. It's kind of daunting to read her diaries, and it's really interesting to read about her in such a non-encryptive manner, because during her books she's very metaphorical. It's very difficult, like her books are extremely difficult to read. I just find her extremely interesting as an author and as a person, so I just really love reading her books. Okay, so next we have The Night Circus by Erin Morgenstern. This was recommended to me by a viewer. I'm really excited. I really don't know what this is about. I know it involves a circus, the night circus, a circus that appears at night. Is that what the book is about? The cover also implies that there's some kind of romance, and we love romance during the summer. We love romance all around, but summer is a great time for romance. And then we have two Jane Austen books. I have to read Emma and Mansfield Park. I just have to this summer. Penguin editions, both were 10 euros in a discount promotion code. So I'm really happy because I know these copies are gonna stay with me forever. A little over 400 pages, so these are gonna be awesome to read. So yeah, Jane Austen on my summer TBR. Okay, great. A lot of viewers have begged me to read Picture of Dorian Gray by Oscar Wilde. I didn't have to get this because my dad had both of these copies, so this, pretty sure these are really old. I don't know. I know this one is because even the pages are yellow. It's a pretty short book, as I can see. It's just like 200 pages, so I'm just excited to read it. It says here, I'm translating, but it says here that the Picture of Dorian Gray caused scandal and controversy. So Dorian Gray is a rich man who sells his soul in exchange. Oh my god, I'm just reading spoilers. I don't read any spoilers. Oh, I know I'm gonna like this. Okay. And also another Oscar Wilde, The Importance of Being Earnest. I believe this is him, right, in the cover. So it's also a little bit chunkier. And this is actually a play. It also doesn't have an introduction or a conclusion. I like those editions with introductions or conclusions, so you can kind of see the reflection of other authors on a particular book. I think that's really interesting. But yeah, so two Jane Austens, two Oscar Wildes. I think this is gonna be a good summer read. And finally, this is an edition of a Charles Dickens book, translated version. I got this a while ago, I think y'all remember, called Bleak House. Charles Dickens, I've only read one book like years ago, Great Expectations, and I don't remember much from it because it was really like 5 years ago. But I do remember it being kind of a reflection on the social working status. I do remember there was some crime involved. I don't really know. So this seems more like an end of the summer read. The book is stained because it was, I believe it's secondhand book. It does feel like an autumn, kind of like at the end of the summer when it starts to get into autumn read, you know what I mean? So I'm saving this one for last. It's also huge, so I think this one will prolong itself until maybe November, December, because once the semester starts, that's when my reading habits kind of halt a little bit. So I'm hoping that I can read this during September, October. I think this is a good read for those months. If I read all of these books, I would be happiest ever. If I do somehow magically read all of these. I can get new ones, browse the library, because I love to browse the library for fictions that I don't exactly want to purchase, but I do want to read. I really love the excitement that comes with summer. I love those really warm days and just being able to walk late in the day, in the evenings, or just relax time for myself and to do all of these hobbies that I really love. I think I will post another finals vlog because I did film a lot, and I think I have another day. I don't know. I'll keep in touch. Thank you so much for 80,000 people here. It's just a freaking amazing, incredible. I don't really know how to thank you. I know a lot of viewers have been with me throughout this whole year, and now I feel like we're coming to the other side, kind of just like, oh, let's close this door now and kind of just move on to the next thing. So that's really amazing, and I feel really proud and just really happy and grateful to have you here with me as always. Stay safe, stay protected, protect your loved ones as well. I haven't gotten vaccinated yet. It's probably gonna happen this month. It's just things, how things are in my country. Yeah, fingers crossed I can get the vaccine. Until then, see you soon. Thank you again for staying a little while. Love you so much.